This is the geothermal system part two. In this video, I'm going to silver solder, in other words, brazing solder the refrigerant lines together. Now, these are flex tubes, and I'm using that because if you've seen the last video, I'm in a crawl space and I have to send the tube down the hole, which is pretty deep. It's about 70 feet. And so I need something that I can get into the crawl space and then unwind into the hole. Now, the refrigerant line, the liquid refrigerant, will come in on this quarter inch. Now, this is because it's refrigerant copper tubing, it's actually 3/8 and they go by the OD. And then we do a return bend and then an expander to 3/8 inch on the ID, and that would be 1/2 inch on the OD. And then this is just flex tube. This is 50 feet, so I'm actually going to have to extend this to 77 because my hole goes down 77 feet. Now, I've got a nitrogen tank here, which is just going to trickle nitrogen gas through the entire loop while I'm soldering. That way, I don't oxidize the inside of the tubing while I'm brazing it together with silver solder. And then obviously it comes out that end. So let's start welding it together. All right, now it's done silver soldering. You can see the joints, they're almost brazed together. I'm going to get a close-up on this. Real high heat way of joining the pipes. This is definitely not plumbing solder. So make sure you do not use plumbing solder on a refrigerant line. The whole time I was soldering this, silver soldering it, or brazing solder is probably a better word, the nitrous oxide tank was pumping nitrogen through the line. So the inside of the pipe, and it's actually still doing it now, I'm going to shut it off. And you want to keep doing that because you don't want oxidation inside your refrigerant line. You can see how it's black on the outside. That's because we're in regular air with oxygen and nitrogen and all kinds of other stuff. So you want to pump pure nitrogen through the center so you don't get any oxidation on the inside. That's bad for the refrigerant. So this is done. I'm going to start adding the little bridges across here, and those I will join with plumbing solder. That way it keeps the pipe separated as I'm sending it down the hole. So the next step is going to be to coat this with the tar to protect it from acid and corrosion, and then send it down the hole. And that's what the next video will be. All right, on this step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start adding spacers. And this is a spacer which I made from one of these, which is pretty common in plumbing. It's a 1-inch mount for 1-inch copper tubing. That way it doesn't scratch the tubing, so it's made out of copper itself. And I just made these so that they would fit real snugly on the tubing. And I'm not going to use silver solder on this because it's not related to the pressure of the refrigerant. It's just something that I'm putting on to hold the two pipes apart while it goes down in the hole. Now I'm going to put it every 4 feet. I'm going to unwind that. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add some tar on the outside of the tubing to protect the tubing from the soil. And that will be the next video. Okay, now this is the refrigerant line with the 1/2 inch and 3/8 inch tube that are going to go down in the hole. And as I showed you on the last video, these were the clamps that I used to hold the pipes apart while I put them down the hole so they don't touch each other. That's just a bracket that was straightened out. If you look at the other side, there's a little eyelet hole in there, and I used that to run a wire through. It just made the sweating a lot easier when you have the wire on there than to sweat it without it. And these are every 4 feet, and they just go all the way down. I laid this out on my lawn so that I can paint the entire drop with a tar so that it won't corrode when it's underground. And I painted the first 4 feet, but I'm going to paint the rest of it now. And then the last step is to roll it up, get it in the crawl space, unroll it inside the hole, and then bury it. And that will be step 2.